A new weapon in the quest to get ahead in the battle against COVID-19.
Yeah, there's a local effort to identify medication with promise for treatment. WGN medical reporter Dina Baer has more.
One drug was identified by researchers at the University of Chicago, but they're not stopping there. With help from scientists at Argonne National Laboratory, they're rapidly combing through all medications that could have power over SARS-CoV-2. And now they're turning to drug companies to launch clinical trials with COVID-19 patients.
But I remember thinking in February that this was going to be a major problem. Many of my colleagues, I think, felt the same way. And many of us all over the world started to do whatever we could to try to help understand this disease.
Fast forward to September, and University of Chicago molecular engineer Juan de Pablo went one step further, understanding and applying knowledge to identify a viable medication.
Maybe it is reassuring to realize that you have all of this knowledge, all of these resources, and you're not sitting idle, and you're trying to do something to help with the control of the disease.
Looking at earlier studies in China, the first candidate was tested, Ebsilin, a drug originally developed to treat bipolar disorder.
And there have been clinical trials against bipolar disorder using Ebsilin. It has been shown to be safe.
And when it comes to COVID-19, it targeted both virus replication and body reaction.
We did not expect this to happen, but it is an effective mechanism, apparently, by which the drug might interfere with the function of the enzyme.
Targeting enzymes and proteins in the virus is the key to unlock a possible cure.
And you can think of the shape of the protein as being the lock, and the drug that we're trying to hook up to that protein is the key. So by using the X-ray microscope, the advanced photon source, to look at the shape of that lock protein, that gives us a lot of insight into how we can design a key that would fit into that lock.
Enter this massive microscope. The overhead view shows a tool that can fit Chicago's Wrigley Field inside it. Scientists at Argonne National Laboratory use the advanced photon source to look for a way to penetrate and destroy virus structure. They inspected billions of compounds.
And we can take basically every drug that's ever been developed and do that screening in the computer and try and do a first pass to identify which ones might actually have a beneficial effect.
After 2 months running computational studies, Argonne experts whittled down potential COVID drug candidates to 5.
And there is light at the end of the tunnel. Never in the face of an epidemic like this has the scientific community and the pharmaceutical community reacted so quickly and so effectively at being able to create what we hope will be treatments in just a few months. I just hope people can hold on a little while longer, but there is light at the end of the tunnel.
Argonne scientists are not only working on identifying drugs, they're researching alternate antivirals, antibodies, even new materials for face masks. Back to you.